This is the tornado. The tornado area of Zion storms introduces concepts about thermodynamics. So the vortex gives us an example of fluids in motion. So you need two things in order for a vortex to form. You need an updraft and you need circular airflow. So as the mist comes up, it's pulled up towards the ceiling, and then additional fans blow the air in a circle, forming the vortex that you see. This is similar to what happens when a vortex or a tornado forms in nature. So you have a giant supercell storm that collides together, and it creates a big updraft of air as well as circular flow when warm and cold air fronts meet. So this will actually show you and demonstrate a little bit about how once a vortex forms, how that moves. So with the exhibit, we can control the fans along the height of the exhibit. So as you open and close these louvers along the side, it effectively creates high and low air pressure systems along the height of the tornado. So it pushes the tornado around and gives it different looks. Sometimes, depending on the airflow, it can be very tight and skinny. Other times it can be very woolly and fat, kind of like what you see behind me now. So this demonstrates that the dynamics of how air and the airflow affects the tornado. You can also put objects in there and move around and chase the tornado around. If I go back and I stand in the tornado, it'll break down for just a moment and tries to figure out how to move around my body. So this happens in nature as well. So you tend to see tornadoes out in big open areas and rural areas where there isn't a lot of things, there aren't a lot of things on the ground to sort of break up the airflow. You don't see them as often in cities. So when I stand in the tornado, I put something else in there inside our vortex, it interrupts the airflow down here at the ground, and it takes it a minute to figure out, the air has to figure out how to move around my body or whatever else I've put in there to reform the vortex around the obstruction. So you can use this exhibit to experiment with how a vortex moves and how airflow impacts them. Now, the tornado was one of the biggest engineering challenges in the whole exhibit. We partnered with artist Ned Kahn to create it, and he has done a lot of these kind of phenomena-inspired and vortex-inspired art pieces. So he had a piece that was about 6 feet tall, and we came to him and we said we wanted to make it very big to inspire a sense of awe and exploration of nature, have people stand in it and be able to control it. And he thought that was a great idea, but wasn't quite sure how we were gonna get there. So he paired him with an engineer to develop the exhibit that you see behind me. So here's how this thing works. The mist that you see is actually a very fine water mist. So in the grates underneath in the center of here, there's an 8-foot wide tub of water. And inside of that tub, we have about 48 ultrasonic foggers that are creating this very fine mist. So all of the fans that drive this are actually up in the ceiling over my head. So we have two fans that create the updraft and two fans that blow back down through these big return ducts and blow across the curved walls to create the rotational motion. Because those are the two things we need for a vortex. We need an updraft and rotation. So those big fans that are each the size of a car, they create the updraft and they also blow back down and rotate it around. So that we knew from the artist, but the biggest challenge when you scale this up is how to handle all of the wet air that we're pumping into the room. Because this is a lot of water mist that's coming up, and there's literally not a desiccant system in the world that can dry the air out at the rate at which we are producing wet air. So bring on the engineers. What we finally figured out is if we couldn't handle and treat all of the air, then we just wouldn't. So that was the big breakthrough in the engineering. Once all of this mist goes up into the ceiling, we actually split it into two parts. One part of that wet air goes through a whole duct system that is totally untouched. The other half, we run through a giant desiccant system, and that is about the size of a school bus, also sitting above my head. And so we can actually change and tune how much we dry that half of the air, depending on how humid it is at any given time of the year. So we have one half of wet, untreated air. The other half of the air we can dry to whatever point we need. And then we recombine those two at the end to get an acceptable level of humidity for this entire gallery. So that was the big challenge that we finally were able to solve to get the exhibit that you see today.